Hey guys, welcome back to Electrical Car Repair. In today's video, guys, we'll be taking apart a quark spring and show you what's inside of it. Just a video out of curiosity, but some of you ask me how it's made or how it works and all that stuff. What it pretty much does, guys, this quark spring is mounted on the steering column like that, and the steering wheel goes on top of it. And when you turn your steering wheel, the cables turn. Okay, you can see the cable turn like that. I'm gonna show you just quick in the car and explain what it does, and we'll take it apart. So you just under that plastic behind the steering wheel right there, and when you turn your steering wheel, okay, you can see the cables turn as well. It transfers the signal from those cables that are connected to the radio switch, phone switch, horn, airbag, and the cruise control. And it could be something else too, depending what your steering wheel comes with. So let's go ahead, take this thing apart now, okay, and see what's inside of it. Now I want to see if I can take apart this connector here first. Okay, this is if it's replaceable. Okay, and looks like this one is probably not. Let me see quick if I can pull it out, because those are the airbag wires, and if your airbag explodes often, okay, you have to replace the quark spring too. This is because the cables will melt. Even if we break it, this one is an old one. Okay, you can see these wires are actually not replaceable on this one. On some vehicles it is. Now let's go ahead, open it and see what's inside of it. It's very important how you install those, the quark springs, and I wouldn't recommend to fix them. Just buy a new one. If you're in the need for one, just get a new one. But if you don't install them the correct way, the same thing will happen again. Okay, now on the inside we have more teeth. Okay, let me get this small screwdriver. You can see how many teeth are in that thing, and it's not as easy to take apart as you think, because okay, I'm just going to break a few of them. So they're not holding. Okay, just one more here. And this is one of the parts that came out. Okay, check out. That's the quark spring. Those are the wires. Okay, and when you turn, the wires turn inside too. Okay, let's see how long those wires are now. Just out of curiosity, I want to see. There is some grease, electrical grease here, and ours. This is the reason why ours didn't work. You can see it came undone, okay, from this connector right here. And as a result, ours didn't work. So practically in our case, this is fixable if we wanted it to, but it takes quite a bit of effort to, okay, pull everything apart, fix everything. You have to solder everything together. This is one of the ends, then the other end need to be connected right here. You can see for both wires, so we have two ribbons of cables, everything inside. So I wouldn't recommend to fix them, guys, but just out of curiosity, you can see what's inside. So thank you for watching, and see you guys next time.